welcome to Coach's Corner. Thanks for being with Coach Mullikin. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great, man. How are you?
I'm pretty good. Not too bad. Let's just start out here. Tell me a little bit about yourself, you know, your story.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I was born and raised in Kansas City. Grew up there, played baseball, football, basketball all throughout my life. Baseball was definitely what God gave me more ability and talent towards, so I took a scholarship to the Savannah College of Art and Design down in Savannah, Georgia. I played there in the Sun Conference for 4 years and realized I wanted to get into coaching. So different opportunities opened up, definitely felt God's hands on a lot of the moves that I've made in transitions. I started at Mid-America Nazarene University, then went from there to a Christian school in Jacksonville, Florida called Trinity Baptist. And then from there, I got my first head coaching job at Toccoa Falls College. I was there for 3 seasons, and then the opportunity opened up at Olivet Nazarene, and now I'm here trying to have a non-COVID year for a complete season. So
yes, are we all?
Yeah, no doubt, no doubt.
What would you say something that's like the biggest difference from Olivet through all the other coaching jobs that you've had?
I would say as a whole, the athletic department is phenomenal. Just the cohesive nature and the way everybody works with each other, how we all pull for each other, how we all help each other. There's definitely no programs on an island that feel like they're untouchable or they're better than anybody else. It's been a great group. And obviously, the facilities and the history of the programs speak for themselves.
Awesome. Would you mind sharing with us something like a cool college memory that you have?
Man, you know, I'm one of the few guys that I have a cool and bad story. So my last regular season start, my senior day was against Weber International. I threw a complete game, 2-hit, 1-run game, absolutely dominated. It was incredible. So we go into the regional thinking that it's just all going to be good. I'm going to kind of continue that success. It's my senior year, and you know how you feel when you're that age. And I go to the regional. I throw the second game. Our number one was a 13th round draft pick, so I was our number two. And I got lit up like a Christmas tree by Northwood University. So I think I went 3 innings, my last outing, and kind of left with a bad taste. And I think that's what encouraged me so much to go into coaching, realizing that I wasn't done with baseball yet.
Gotcha. No, it's cool to have a personal story from that. When you're growing up, what sports did you play?
Yeah, I played baseball, football, and basketball. I loved them all. I was terrible at basketball. You know, I think from day one, I was the starting quarterback. From day one, I was the starting shortstop. And even in sixth grade basketball, I was a defensive specialist. So I didn't shoot. But yeah, you know, I loved playing all sports. Loved the team atmosphere of it. Loved the camaraderie, the friendships, and the bonds that you built through that.
Cool. So growing up, you didn't know you wanted to be a coach, did you?
No, not at all. I never pictured myself doing it. I had a great little league coach. My high school coach, wasn't the best experience, as I know a lot of guys have. In college, it was a rocky road. As far as my relationship with my head coach, we've since mended fences, but I didn't really realize I wanted to get into coaching until really God just kind of kept plopping opportunities in my lap, and just felt more natural to me, and I just enjoyed getting to know the guys and building those relationships and really doing life with them.
Okay, so we're gonna change routes just a little bit right here. So do you have a ridiculous fact that you know? Just something out of the blue, anything. What's a fact that you just know?
I'm not a fat guy.
You're not a fat guy?
No, not a fat guy. The most recent one was, the Chicago White Sox, the Giolito that threw the last no-hitter. Had a swing and miss of 30%. Which is absolutely insane, and that's on all of his pitches. It wasn't just like his strikes or his sliders. I mean, maybe that's a
baseball fact.
That's a random baseball fact, but yeah, the fact that he had a 30% swing and miss. I think the only thing that's been that high was probably my freshman year when I tried to hit in college. So yeah, that's probably about the only time that a swing and miss has been that high.
So you were a pitcher?
I was. I signed as a middle infielder, and I like to kind of joke and say that I swung my way into the bullpen my freshman fall. It was a much faster game. I went from as a big fish in a small pond, and then went to school with a lot of really good guys.
Gotcha. Okay. So I got a random question here.
Yeah.
So if you were a martial artist and you had to break a board with your fist,
okay,
do you think you could demonstrate the sound for me that you would make breaking that board?
Oh, man. Man, I just feel like, my guys give me enough of a hard time as it is. I'm just going to be giving them more fodder. But, yeah, man, I think it's just going to be like the,
Okay.
Right? Yeah?
Yeah.
Maybe? No? Alright.
I think I might do it. I think I might get it. Alright, so this is the time we're going to change segments. I call this a bit or this or that segment.
Awesome.
All you got to do is answer this or that.
Okay.
So, alright. First one, I got Coke or Pepsi?
Coke.
Coke? You say soda or pop?
Coke.
You say Coke? Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, it's all yet.
Whoa.
You want a Coke, sorry.
No.
I'm a weird guy. I've lived a lot of places, so.
City or country?
Country.
Country? Are you a morning or night person?
Morning.
Okay. Dog or cat?
Dog, 100%.
100% dog. You got a dog?
I've got two dogs. English Bulldog and a Black Lab.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Are you more of like a Facebook, Twitter, Instagram?
Twitter, because that's how I recruit.
Okay. iOS or Android?
iOS. I don't understand why people would have a Samsung device.
Oh, hurt.
Okay. You're a lot bigger than I am, so yeah, Androids are cool. You know, there's nothing wrong with that.
Cool. Work hard or play hard?
Oh, play hard.
Play hard? Okay, what about bath or shower?
Shower.
Shower all the way?
Yeah, ain't nobody got time for that.
No? Alright, we're going to transition again, different segment.
Alright, let's go.
This one, I call it, you know, I actually don't have a name for it, but it's the first it's the first thing that you say whenever I say a word. What's the first thing that comes to mind? Just fire it off, alright? First word, we got sports.
Baseball.
Okay. Soda.
Diet Coke.
Okay. Parent.
My dad.
COVID-19.
I think I've signed a couple things of my employment with all of that. Where the first word that comes to my mind's not there, but challenge.
Challenge. 2020.
Brutal.
Mask.
I look good in it.
Let's go second.
Second.
Second, like a second.
Like oh, Jordan Feldman, second baseman.
Okay. What about a minute?
I go back to college and time runs.
Okay. About strike.
Oh, better be 70%, so yeah.
Jesus.
My Lord and Savior.
Okay, cool. And now this is the last segment I got here. I call it, it's time to get a little bit more serious. Alright, okay. You know, I call it tough talks.
Okay.
So here I got a paper right here for you. I just want you to read off A and B as fast as you can for
us. Oh man, this is brutal. Alright. Keep in mind, guys, I went to art school not because I was a good test taker, but with grammar or math. So, Silly Sally swiftly shoots seven silly sheep. The seven silly sheep, Silly Sally shoots. Silly Sally, these sheep shouldn't sleep in a sack. Sheep shouldn't sleep in a shed. I thought, but the thought I thought wasn't the thought I thought. I thought, if the thought I thought, I thought, I hadn't thought, I wouldn't have thought so much.